po si John at welcome ulit sa Thinking Math Channel. Sa huling video, ay paliwanag ko sa inyo kung ano ang isang irregular figure sa pamamagitan ng pagbibigay ng mga halimbawa. Ang area kasi ng isang irregular figure ay hindi nakukuha ang kanyang kabuuang area kapag hindi ito hinahati para magkaroon tayo ng mga regular figures. Kagaya ng square or rectangle. Sa topic na ito, matututo naman kayo ng iba pang paraan kung paano makuha ang total area ng isang irregular figure. Para mas lalo nyong maintindihan ang mga sinasabi ko, panoorin nyo ang video nito. Hello guys! Para po sa una nating halimbawa, pag-aralan po natin itong irregular figure na ito. Para po makuha ang area ng figure na ito, hanap po tayo ng paraan para itong irregular figure na ito ay maging isang regular figure. So, ang gagawin po natin, ay magdodraw ako ng line dito sa taas. Ito po, red line. So, kung napapansin nyo, itong figure na ito kanina ay naging isa na pong regular figure. And dito po na side, meron pa tayong 5 units. And dito po sa babang linya ay meron po tayong 5 units. So madaling sabi, itong side na po na ito ay magiging length at dito po sa baba ay magiging width. At this point, applying now the formula of area of rectangle. Since alam naman po natin na ang rectangle ay isang regular figure. So A is equals to length times width. Kung inyo pong napapansin, instead po na big letter A ay small letter A ang aking ginamit. Ang ibig pong sabihin, itong irregular figure na ito ay kinonvert ko nating regular figure. So kung mapapansin nyo, meron po tayong blank space dito. So, applying this formula, ang ating masosolve na area ay itong kabuuan na area na ito. Dahil mamaya po ay katanggalin po natin o ibabawas itong blank space na ito. Since L is equals to 5 units, ito po yon, and width is equals to 5 units, ito po yon. So applying the formula now, A is equals to length times width, A is equals to 5 units times 5 units, and your A is equals to 25 square units. Ito po yung sinasabi ko. Itong A is equals to 25 square units ay itong kabuuan na area po nitong figure na ito kasama na po itong blank space na ito. Okay, magpatuloy po tayo. Ito po yung sinasabi ko kanina. Ito pong blank space nito ay atin pong ibabawas. Kung napapansin nyo, itong square na ito, atin po itong bibilangin, yung square na ito na blank spaces. So, meron po tayong 1, 2, 3, and 4 blank spaces. Therefore, blank spaces is equals to 4 square units outside the irregular figure. Dito po, sinasabi po na outside the irregular figure. Kasi ito po yung irregular figure natin, itong color blue. And itong color green, ito po yung blank space natin na outside the irregular figure. At this point, we can now solve the area of irregular figure. So the final formula is big letter A is equals to small letter a minus the blank spaces. So A is equals to 25 square units minus 4 square units. So ang final answer natin is A is equals to 21 square units. Punta naman po tayo sa pangalawang example. So, tulad ng nauna, itong irregular figure na ito ay i-convert po natin into a regular figure. So, ang gagawin natin ay ganito. Dito po sa taas ay maglalagay po tayo ng guhit. Ito po, yung red lines. Kung mapapansin nyo, itong figure nito ay isa na pong regular figure. Itong regular figure nito ay mayroong 5 units in this side and 6 units in this side. Therefore, itong side po na ito ay magiging length and this side ay width. Now, applying the formula of area of rectangle, A is equals to length times width. Since L is equals to 5 units and W is equals to 6 units, A is equals to length times width and A is equals to 5 units times 6 units. Therefore, our A is equals to 30 square units. Ang ibig sabihin po ng 30 square units ay ito pong kabuuang area ng figure na ito kasama na po yung blank spaces. Sa puntong ito, bibilangin na po natin yung blank spaces. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 blank spaces. So, blank spaces is 6 square units outside the irregular figure. So, nasa labas po siya ng irregular figure kasi itong color blue na ito, ito lang po yung irregular figure natin. Hindi kasama itong blank spaces na color red. Now, we can find the area of irregular figure. So, A is equals to small letter A minus the blank spaces. So, A is equals to 30 square units minus 6 square units. Then, the answer is A is equals to 24 square units. For the third and the last example, I will teach you on how to estimate the area of an irregular figure in the easiest method. How can we do that? First, we're going to put a grid lines on top of this irregular figure. There. Now, you can clearly see those squares inside the irregular figure because of the grid lines. So, what are you going to do now is count those squares inside the irregular figure. So, we count. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21. We have 21 squares inside the regular figure. If one square is equals to one unit, therefore your area is equals to 21 square units, meaning the area of this irregular figure is 21 square units. It's pretty easy, di ba?
Maraming salamat po sa panood. Hanggang sa susunod na video po. Bye-bye!